My name is Nathan McNett. I'm a soil conservationist with the Natural Resource Conservation Service in Lenawee County out of the Adrian Field Office. And today we're going to look at a WASCOB site, a water and sediment control basin. We've got a small watershed upstream of the first instance of erosion, you know. So we got 8 or 10 acres upstream of the erosion. And then we have a broad basin here. You can see how this is very broad. And so if you put an embankment across here, you're going to store a lot of water back behind there. And that's what we want to do. We want to store the 10-year storm at least. And so if this was a very narrow draw going down the field, you know, and you put an embankment across there, you don't have very much of a storage basin behind that. So that would probably be a site where you'd rather go with a grass waterway. So above this WASCOB system, we have about 8 acres or so where the watershed breaks right up there at those buildings, at those barns. And the water that falls on those barns and stuff comes this way. And beyond the barns, it sheds the other direction. And so this watershed's coming down here, and there used to be, you know, it had nothing to stop it until it went all the way down to the woods. And so there was a gully started here and just got progressively deeper and deeper until it got down there. At which point it was like 10 or 12 feet deep down at the woods. And so we came up to the where the water started cutting, and we started to get the gully up at the top end of here, and we placed our first embankment. And then we've gone with a series of them. There's 3 of them in a row to cut off the watershed again and again. And we can do some calculations that tell us, you know, based on soil types and things, where the second one should go. And so then we say, okay, well, the second one needs to go within this many feet of the first one based on our calculations. Otherwise, we'll start cutting again. And so we then look at the farmer's operation and say, how wide is his equipment? And then we'll pull that back to some increment of his equipment. Say he's 60 feet wide, you know, we'll do some multiple of 60. Or if he's only 30 feet wide, we'll do some multiple of 30 so that he has an even number of passes between the embankments. They've been really happy with them, and you can see that we don't have any erosion here anymore. This is called a blind inlet, and they've installed these on each one of their WASCOB dikes down through this system now. Where normally down here on the inlet, we would have a Hickenbottom riser. You've probably seen these orange risers coming up out of the field here and there that take the water into the tile. Well, here we've got a bed of pea gravel put down over an array of tiles down there that let the water filtrate down through this pea gravel and into the tile that way, and so we don't get any trash or anything else going down into the tile. And they also helps the farmer that they're not going to hit this with the tillage equipment and knock the riser over like they often will in the old school type of situation where we had a Hickenbottom riser there. We seed these things down with the same sort of a mix that you would use on your grass waterway, with like a tall fescue waterway type of mix. It's got a lot of creeping red fescue. That's the finer stuff. The coarser stuff would be the tall fescue, and it really makes a dense sod quickly. And we really seed it down heavy, like 150 pounds the acre. Speaking of maintenance, you know, you kind of want to be able to mow these things. So we put the side slopes pretty broad so that, you know, you could get up there with a mower or something. Because you get woody shrubs and trees and stuff growing on these things, and they'll compromise their integrity, and they can let water find its way through the roots, channels, and you can start to get a cut through here, and you don't want that. And you just have erosion all over again. We can get the NRCS engineering staff involved to help design these, or you could go through a technical service provider, private company, to get these built. And any good earthworking company can build these. And we design them with a 4 foot at least flat top, so you could mow that. And then they have these side slopes that are right around 5 to 1. We got a lot of earthwork contractors that can do this work, no problem. Engineering practices like WASCOB, when you want to enroll in the CREP, you really need nearly complete design before you even go to the Farm Service Agency and say, we'd like to enroll in some WASCOBs. Because you do need to know how many cubic yards of fill are required, because they're going to be doing some cost share on that. And how long is it? Because then we're going to put a buffer upstream. And so length times width divided by 5, 3, you know. And you get acreage, you know, how many acres. You need to know how many acres is going to be planted to that buffer area. And so really you need to kind of get the design locked into place before you can go to FSA with a, you know, with an offer. And really there's no way around that other than getting an engineering design, a preliminary draft or something in place.